This is CBUS Enterprises.
22 boxes. £250,000. Just one question. Welcome to Deal or No Deal. The Dream Factory is open for business this weekend. I hope you're having a wonderful time. Thank you for making Deal part of your weekend. Let me tell you about some of the people here in the East Wing. People who have got dreams. Well, they've all got dreams, but there are three really important dreams, which I'd like you to bear in mind if one of these people is today's player. This is Ben, and his dream is to tell a knock-knock joke to Her Majesty the Queen. This is Tracy, who, if she wins enough, she dreams of opening an Outward Bound school and assault course for fairies. And this is Mark, and he dreams of taking his cabaret act to Las Vegas. He has a troupe of line-dancing ducks. Their dreams take many shapes and sizes. We try and make them come true here. Wank. Here are the names. So, on this Sunday of dreams, will it be Ben, Laura, or Mark? It's Tom. Tom, the Walk of Wealth is yours. The pound table awaits, and the crazy chair has got your name on the back. Okay, we've got Tom Lapthorne from Plimpton in Devon.
Yep.
A self-employed carpenter.
Yeah.
You're here by accident.
Yeah.
Tell me about the accident.
Well, back in 2007, I made the mistake of getting on a motorbike. Had a bit of a harsh crash. I had a head-on with another vehicle. And, yeah, I went catapulting off my bike into a hedge. And I really badly damaged my knee, breaking my left leg, and I broke my left arm as well, as you can see the scar there.
Wow, that is a super scar.
Yeah, broke the bone clean in half, so had to be plated.
Ooh.
Yeah, and whilst I was in hospital, I just had a big think about life, really, and just decided that I had a bit of money saved up that I was going to buy a house with. But I just decided to just go travelling and just do different things, basically, like this.
So. Yeah. Because that came out of the blue, and then you suddenly realise how precious life is.
Exactly,
and you've decided to make the most of your life. There's a reminder of how bad it was. I guess you kind of want to say, where were you, in Derriford?
That's right, yeah.
Yeah. So no doubt you want to say thanks to the people down there.
Yeah, without a doubt.
Put you back
Great
together
care.
Again. OK. Oh! Oi, oi. Hello? You want to, the banker wants to see the photo again. Yes, banker? The banker wants to know whether there was an extremely good-looking nurse in the room.
I'll take that as a compliment.
You should take it as a compliment. He's very worried he's taking on more than he can handle today. So, having had a bad accident, you decided to follow it with that. That is bonkers. Where is that?
In Cairns, Australia. Wow. I actually completed 13 bungee jumps that day.
13?
Yeah, I did an unlimited bungee all day long. Did blindfolded, running off, backwards.
Don't tell me you were my height before you did that. All right, well, I feel as if we've learnt a lot more about you. And, well, you've got your mate Simon with you, haven't you?
Yeah, I have.
Hello, Simon. And so will you be giving assistance, or are you just one of these people who've come along as a complete waste of space?
Yeah, that one.
No, I'll give assistance if he needs assistance, but I'm pretty sure I can do most of it on his own.
Great. OK. All right, well, I hope the two of you do really well out of this game, but you are the major man here, Tom, and I need you please to confirm you chose box number 8 at random before the game began.
I did, though.
It is sealed by the independent adjudicator who seals all 22 boxes and is the only person who knows where the money is.
Yep.
On Friday, when it was Harold's game, I asked him how he was going to do it, and he said, by picking numbers.
I'm going by that same sort of plan.
Same principle.
Yeah.
Tom, do it for Devon. Good luck.
Thank you. Just want to start off by saying, I was wondering if in the first 5 boxes I got the 1p that you would kiss them for me out here in slow motion.
I don't think that would be a popular decision.
What do you reckon? Yeah. Is that a deal?
It's a deal.
Well,
come on, choose Joyce.
In that case, we'll go with Joyce.
Yeah, come on, Joyce. Come on, Joyce. I love a drop of cider, me lovely.
Do you, my darling?
I bet you got it all over your lips.
And voila.
Oh, what a shame. Just missed it.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Yeah. So am I, Joyce.
Yeah.
Glenda, please, number 12.
Oh, dear. Give us 1p, Glenda.
I'll try. Good luck, Tom.
Thank you.
You're a brilliant guy.
Oh, no. My word. You didn't want to do that. You like your reds. Dear me. Joyce, Glenda, I was really looking forward to that moment.
Oh, never mind. It's almost the next time.
G, 19, please.
Come on, G.
Best of luck, Tom.
That
come
is
on, Tom.
Incredibly
come on, Tom. Turn it around, eh?
Sorry, darling.
Sorry, Tom, turn it around, mate.
Come on, Tom. All joking aside, you've got to find the 1p now to balance it.
Matt, number 6.
You're smashing, Blake, Tom. All the best.
Cheers, Matt.
He is desperate for blue now. Slow is slow.
You make your own mind up.
Is it sort of...
Yeah, like that.
That's slow.
You just go down there.
Yes. Oh, no! No!
Well, Matt, cheers for that.
Well, we're back to the game, and that was exactly what you wanted to do.
Exactly.
Yeah, you just need another one like that.
Go with Joe, number 9, please.
All the best, Tom.
Thank you.
10p, come on, we'll have full sex. I don't know where that came from. Sorry about that. To you, your husband and family, I apologise.
Oh, it's blue, but I'm not sure about 10p. Yeah!
that's an opening round we're not going to forget for a while. Hello, banker.
Just listen to him.
I assume you've enjoyed the game so far. When he saw that flash of 10 just for a second there, he thought this was going to be a very different show. The late night one. Right, can we concentrate on Tom? He's a risk taker. Yeah, yeah. Over the years, we have the proof that when people take big numbers right at the beginning, quite often they turn into gamblers. Okay. I agree. He says it's a very, very good offer, and he's not taking you lightly. 6,500.
That's a good offer.
6,500 when you've taken the top two out of the game. 6,500 is a very good opening offer.
Very good, considering I took the two top ones. But that kiss, obviously, made him bump his offer up. Thank you, now.
Yeah, could we forget about it now?
I'm ready for the question.
£6,500, deal or no deal?
No deal.
Come on, Tom. Now we want a blue spruce.
I've got a few numbers I'm going to keep, but I won't tell you quite yet.
Oh, thanks.
Linda, number three, please.
All right.
Good luck, mate.
Thank you.
I hope you get what you want.
Poker player from the pool. True?
True.
Yeah. Blue, please.
It's all right.
Three grand.
That's fine, that's fine. Big one last time, didn't you?
Yeah, I did, yeah.
Go with you, mate.
Yeah?
Yeah. Please,
I
Justin.
Wish you all the best.
Cheers, mate. Yes!
A lot of passion in this game.
Oh, oh mate. Thanks for that. Yeah,
I'll tell you something, Tom, that's, there is real passion in this game. You got people who want you to do well. Why should people come back to your game?
Because there's no doubt about it, I'm going to win big, big money. And Noel might kiss someone again.
No, he might win big money. Come back. From Devon. Had a really bad motorcycle accident and completely re-evaluated what he wanted to do with his life. Went travelling, did a lot of things, and applied for Deal or No Deal. And after we've opened this box, I'll tell you about one of his major ambitions. But where are you going now?
Becca, 14.
Becca, I think it's pretty clear what we don't want to see and what we crave. Thank you.
Try my best. Good luck, Tom.
Wow. In two rounds, you've taken the three biggest boxes in the game. Don't know what to say. That's rather taken the wind out of our sails there. And there's you with the ambition that you want to be immortal. That's what it says in your file.
That's right.
It says down here, one of his greatest wishes is to become immortal and have less hair on his bottom. One of those is achievable.
The laser treatment.
Here is Happy Man. Hello, Mr. Banker. You think it's a very sensible ambition? You're jealous of him. He's young. He's tall. He's handsome. And his mate, the mate he's brought with him, he's the same. Ah, he says, the two of you there, he's getting really upset. It's like taking on a boy band. Ooh, he says, you're going to need a lot of luck. And you're going to have to go a long way into this game to get any meaningful money. Right now, he'll buy it, but he'll only buy it for $3,000. Oh, have a groan, have a tut, have a boo. I don't mind. $3,000 is the offer for the box. Thank you.
Ask me the question, Noel.
£3,000. Deal or no deal?
No deal.
No. You're going to have to go on. That configuration, you're going to have to go on. And maybe to the end. Maybe to the very end.
I think now would be the time for an all-blue round, wouldn't it, really?
What a great idea. Come on.
Mark, number two. Been a brilliant lad to me since I've been here.
Listen, man, you've been my wingman, and I'm going to miss you so much. I think the world of you, and I hope this is the first blue for you.
Oh, I don't know what it is about this game, but when people start being nice to each other like that, it always seems to then throw up a damaging box. Right. Find two blues.
Clive, number seven, mate.
Clive, welcome to the game.
Welcome for Q.
Did you just say welcome to me as well?
I did, actually, by mistake.
Welcome, Clive, welcome.
Well, thank you.
Well done for doing it for us. Right, we need a blue. Thank you. Yes. Yeah. One more.
I'm looking too far into the numbers. It's just boxes.
Yeah. Don't overcomplicate it.
18. Chris.
All right, Chris, we need another blue.
Tom, good luck, mate. You're a great guy.
Come on, one cheer, applause. Oh, my word. And you broke the box.
Sorry.
Sorry about
Sorry,
that.
Sorry, mate.
That's all right.
Oh. Hello. You'll pay for that. He didn't mean to break it, honestly, Guff. They need to be opened with finesse. Great big yob.
Yes, Mr. Banger.
Actually, he didn't say that bit. I said that bit. Okay.
Yes, Mr. Redmond's.
Right, Tom. Yes, 35,000 on that board is a big loss. We recognise that, but we're feeling good at the moment. He says to get any change in this offer, you're going to have an all-blue round in this offer at this point because you took the 35,000. Is two grand. Ooh. But you can see, just as we got there, it tripped up, went through the hedge.
It's making it easy for me.
Yep.
Yeah. You can ask me the question now. No.
Okay. Fair enough, Tom. It's your game. £2,000. Deal or no deal?
No deal.
Thank you. The offers are making it easy for him, and they are.
Just going to have to believe that I've got one of those top reds in there.
Yep, good thing.
And that is what's going to get me through, so...
Excellent.
Laura, number 20, please.
All right, Laura. It doesn't need any commentary, this. The banker's said it. He needs an all-blue round. Thank you.
Good luck, Tom.
Yes! Good.
Don't know why I keep looking at Emiliana. Well, I do know why, but... I'll go with you, please.
Best of luck, Tom,
your
top bloke.
Doing anything for you, these numbers?
My date of birth is 10th of the 11th, 85. I've kept that. And 70, I've recently just split from my girlfriend. I'd always said I'd keep her birthday, so I'm thinking about getting rid of that one.
Why did you split?
No particular reason, just sort of time went by.
Tom, tell the truth, boy.
Give us a clue. Just give us a flavour of it.
He'll say some. He'll say a lie.
In the relationship.
There was a third person in the relationship.
He's behind you.
Well, he does have two diamond earrings, so gives it away. No, it wasn't him. Right, I want to get back to the game now.
Right, this is a really important box. It has to be blue.
Yazza, mate, 21.
Good luck, mate.
Yazza? Oi, oi, oi. Did you hear what I said? It's got to be blue.
It will be blue.
Are you guaranteeing it's blue?
Definitely.
What are you prepared to do if it's not blue?
Kiss you?
No! They've gone kissing mad. Come back after the break. Welcome back to Tom's Game. Mr. Carpenter, Russell Clifton in Devon. You know, every single game you can pin a description on, because every game is different. And I would say this has been a hard struggle so far, not just in gameplay terms, but also in terms of getting Yasser to understand that it must be a blue. Forget any notion of kissing or anything like that, right? OK, yep. I've done my kiss. Yep. Thank you.
No problem. Good luck, Tom.
Oh. Tom. You are doing this the hard way, but, hey, Tom, 50 grand could be here. 50 grand could be in that box.
That's what I've got to keep believing, this.
Yep, absolutely. You believe it and let him fear it. Yes. What did he say last time that you found interesting? Oh, I see that you're making it easy for him. Well, he says the truth is you're making it easy for him. That's interesting. I think he's come up with an offer that you definitely want to think about. You started at 6.5, you dropped to 3, we've yep. dropped to 2. But, yeah, he'll buy your box now for 5,000.
Yeah, that's a good offer.
It is. I think that's worth it. Woo, yeah. Yeah. It's got the pilgrims thinking.
I mean, that's not the money I came here for, but considering the way my game is going, that is a brilliant offer.
Tom.
Yes, mate.
That's an amazing offer, but if 50 grand's in your box, you're going to get rid of the 250, the 75,000, 100,000.
Yeah. No, but my luck doesn't seem to be in today. Mark, any words of advice, mate?
£5,000 is a great offer. You have to think about that. I don't want to see you going away with nothing, Tom, but, you know, once in a lifetime chance, so you might want to take it a bit further.
Tom?
Yes, mate.
You said, you know, your luck's not in today, but you have to make your own luck.
Exactly, exactly. OK, now you can ask me the question.
Tom, £5,000. Deal or no deal?
No deal.
Good luck. Good luck. With the game he's been having, that was brave. It's eluded you so far. We do need a low-value all-blue round.
Number one. Dawn.
Dawn. All-blue round.
Good luck, Tom.
Thank you.
Blue to you.
Another red goes. And what arrives is the thought that maybe it is not your lucky day, and this is the round that kills the game.
£22, please. Lovely Courtney.
We don't want an all-blue five box. Strip one out, please, Courtney.
I really hope it's the template, Dawn.
Oh! Oh! And now, all the peanuts.
Number 11, please. Tracy.
Tracy. He's out of it. If it is, the round from hell.
Won't be.
And the only good news in that round is you took the lowest figure off the board and not the highest. Oh, you'll be very happy now. Thank you. Okay, well, you didn't take the biggest, you did take the lowest. It's the big one that is holding the offer up. It was at £5,000, and now he is prepared to buy the box for £4,000. Which, yeah, gets a woo, because, you know, this has not been... Yeah, no. Absolutely.
So, think in your mind what you would do with that £4,000, and then weigh up the pros and cons, what you want. You can do a lot with £4,000.
Is there a bigger dream associated with teaching football?
Well, I'd like to go to Gambia in Africa and teach for 12 weeks. You can do, like, voluntary, I can teach them football and that. That trip would cost me about £3,000. That is something I want to do. But I want to do lots of other stuff as well.
Interesting.
It's just make or break this moment, isn't it?
Yeah, interesting dilemma for a young man of 23. Do you go for it? Mm. If you have the All Blue round, it's going to be a lot more than 4,000.
Can I get a sweep on what you think I should do?
So it's advice, so you don't have to give it if you feel you don't wish to. Should he deal or no deal, Ben?
Personal choice. Maybe say no, have another go.
Chris?
For yourself, I think you should deal.
No deal.
Mark?
I'm going to say go for it, mate.
Yeah?
We're going to stop there. I'm going to go with Mark's.
OK, sorry, yes, sir.
You can ask me the question now.
OK, £4,000. Deal or no deal?
No deal.
Mark, you feel this one, don't you?
I do.
I mean...
I think the world of him, and I give him honest advice. Go for it, mate.
This is a classic deal scenario, to be honest. Mark has now influenced Tom to go on. So I hope it works for your friendship. Three blues. And what an atmosphere here. Where are you going?
Ben, number 10.
Ben, first of all, pull the seal on box number 10, please. Put your hands on the side of the lid. There is only one thing we have to miss in this round, and I hope you ain't got it. Open it.
Good luck.
Yep.
Well done. Well done. He's got it.
Five, 17, 13, numbers you're not likely to forget, whichever way this goes.
Well, I don't know why, my brother Lucas said to me, for no apparent reason, he just said five. So I'm going to keep that one, and eight.
OK, so these are the two.
We'll go with... No.
Oh, now what?
Now, go with 13.
Why did you stop?
Because I can't decide whether to keep 17, my ex's birthday, or not. But we'll go with 13 now. We'll see where that takes us first.
Mo, we have to miss it. Open box 13, please. We want to see a flash of blue. Do it as fast as you want.
Best one.
Yeah! Come on.
This is a really hard decision.
God, it's such an important decision, because if the 50K is still in the game, they'll have to give you a massive offer to try and stop you. but it's all on this box. I'm right. Yes, thank you. Yeah, if you don't hit the 50,000 in this box, he is willing to purchase your box for 18,000. If you do hit it, it'll be £18. Well, that's different. If you stop right now, he'll give you 9,000. I cannot recall him doing that, Tom.
Tom, 9 grand's a great offer. It's just that those two boxes mean something to you. That's the only thing making the decision hard.
Well, he's good, isn't he? I mean, he does spot on. Oh, he hit you right in a soft spot there. This one's associated with your brother. This one with your ex-girlfriend. And he's actually saying, well, you don't have to go there, Tom. You don't even have to take the risk.
Tom, was your girlfriend ever unlucky for you?
Never, mate.
Maybe you should leave this box in.
Maybe I should take it out.
Go with your gut feeling.
No, I'm ready for the question.
Tom.
Yep.
£9,000. Deal or no deal?
No deal.
Pull the seal.
We got this for you, Tom.
We know. If it's not red, the next offer's 18,000. And we know if it's red, it's 18 quid. Lift it.
Sorry, mate.
I tried.
That's painful. Ah, Tom, you did give it a good shot. But we know what it is now. And it is a very, very small sum of money. Hello. OK, as forecast, as predicted, it's £18.
You can ask me a question.
£18, deal or no deal?
No deal.
50p or 250p. And a game that just a few seconds ago could have brought you at the age of 23 £50,000 may well be about to deliver into your life 50 pence. I hope not. It is the way it goes. It's why it's such a compulsive game. Dave, finish it off, please.
Bad luck, Tom.
Open the box, close the game. We were having quite a laugh throughout the game, and then there was a light-hearted discussion about your personal life. Is it difficult for you now to come to terms with what was an emotional decision?
Yeah. Oh, I knew I shouldn't have chosen that one. I'd always take my brother's word, though, over anyone, so... That's why I chose that one.
I do hope it's not going to change your attitude to life.
Definitely not, no. I'm going to carry on. I'll still get to my dreams. It'll just take me a bit of time, that's all. A bit of hard work. I am majorly disappointed there. As you can tell.
We feel it. We feel it for you, Tom. When the emotional disappointment has gone, remember, you gave it your best shot. And that is the mark of a great deal player. It's been a pleasure to meet you.
Thank you, Noel.
I don't know why I always feel extra disappointed over a weekend when it goes wrong. I suppose it's because we all want to feel good over the weekend. We delivered you compelling television there, but we didn't deliver you the emotional result that we all wanted, the financial result he craved. Hey, I hope you enjoy the rest of the weekend. Tomorrow, the start of a fresh week, and you'll never know what's going to happen in this amazing place. Enjoy the rest of the weekend. Bye-bye.